after experiencing the beauty of Page, Arizona at infamous spots such as Lake Powell and Horseshoe Bend, it was time to haul down to the magical town of Sedona. Two full days were spent exploring red rocks, watching sunsets, and even chasing donuts. From there, we made the trek to Tusayan to check out one of the seven wonders of the world. However, things didn't go quite as planned. We found ourselves ending our trip about 2 days early.
Member of the information.
Good morning, fam. Welcome. We've successfully found a great campsite last night. There's some national forest land, literally about 2 miles outside of the park gate. It was about 14 degrees, and it definitely kind of paid its toll on us, I think. The van is completely kind of frozen over from condensation freezing and things like that. And we were running the heater periodically through the night, but it was just about 40 degrees when I looked at the temperature inside the van. We are currently heading back into the town of Tusayan. Due to COVID right now, not all of the gates and access roads are open. So we are on the south rim of the Grand Canyon, having used the south entrance, and we're a little bit low on groceries and things like that. So we're gonna run into the town just this morning briefly to kind of get what we need, do a bathroom run. And then today is just reserved for exploring the Grand Canyon. What's up, crew? If you can't tell, I guess maybe by my jacket, I am back in Park City, and based on the title of this video, our Southwest Arizona trip ended about 2 days prematurely. Now there's a few reasons as to why this happened, and this episode might look just a little bit different, so I'm gonna kind of be cutting between some of the footage that I have and then me trying to enhance the story from the van back in Park City. But before I do that, I wanna fill you guys in on something. Unfortunately, I found some water like underneath my kitchen base cabinet, which is never a good sign. So I looked in the cabinet and I saw that my water filter cracked and basically broke again. And if you remember a few weeks ago at this point, that same thing happened and my water broke and all that stuff. You can see this is the filter and it cracked, and that's just no bueno. Probably not gonna reinstall that filter right away because I think it's just gonna do the same thing, crack and break, and it is like 70 bucks, so it's definitely not a cheap part. So I'm probably just gonna reorder one so I have it, and then honestly probably just wait until like the spring or summer when it's a little warmer to actually put it back in, because it's just stupid. And I have the heater running right now because it is cold out, so yeah, this is what it's like in the van at these temperatures during this time of the year. So to get to the actual video, in episode 90 we were in Sedona. It was absolutely beautiful. And basically the last third of the trip, our plan was to hit Zion National Park. But there's basically two main reasons why I think we decided not to, and we decided to actually just come home. In this time lapse, actually, I remember we were booking the shuttle for Zion National Park. If you're unfamiliar with Zion, it is absolutely beautiful. Arguably one of the best national parks in the world, to be honest, but you have to use their shuttle system to get into the park where all the hikes are. But because of COVID-19, you have to reserve your spot on the shuttle, because usually they just pack everyone in there like sardines and you're on your way for 10 minutes up into the canyon. So we had to do this the day before we wanted to ride the shuttle at 9 a.m. Mountain Standard Time. So we were literally just outside the Grand Canyon and I hopped on to reserve right at 9 a.m. And long story short, we just could not get three tickets at all for the shuttle. It basically filled up. We had some trouble in the beginning, like it wasn't verifying. It thought we were robots, so it didn't go through. And then before we knew it, like 5-7 minutes later, literally every single time slot was full and we just like couldn't get into the park. It kind of made us like call an audible basically on what we were gonna do. So because we were outside the Grand Canyon already, we're like, we're not gonna come this way and not go see it. So we decided to venture into the park. We were on the south rim and we walked around the south rim of the Grand Canyon. It was freezing cold. Let me tell you, there was a ton of people and just the wind and the temperatures. It was a cool experience, but it was very, very cold. The coolest part about our like 2-3 hours of the Grand Canyon was when we basically were approached by these mountain goats. We had been watching these mountain goats literally scale the side of the Grand Canyon, like on 2-inch ledges, just like jump around like it's no problem. And all of a sudden I started seeing these mountain goats like walking around kind of behind us, and I was like, they're gonna come right next to us because there's no other where to go. And I got this like incredible raw footage, I feel like, of just like these mountain goats coming right towards us and then kind of walking around these rocks. It was a really beautiful experience to see two of these mountain goats so close to us, just kind of strolling along the Grand Canyon like it was nothing. So that was definitely the icing on the cake for me at the Grand Canyon, because our spirits were just kind of low in general. So it's a cool kind of refresher. And if you've never been to the Grand Canyon, it's absolutely just breathtaking, the scale of this thing. So at this point, we were 10 and a half hours from Park City, and it was already about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So basically making the trek all the way home like just didn't make sense. We didn't really have to. So we kind of just started working our way back up north, and we drove about 5 hours to a place called Kanab, and we found an awesome campsite there, again, and just in like some BLM land, literally like in sand dunes. It was really, really cool. And we parked up there for the night, another freezing cold night, but it was a beautiful campsite. After we woke up in the morning, kind of got moving, we headed out to the sand dunes, which was really, really cool, and just kind of hung out there for a little bit. Again, it was freezing cold, lots of wind. It was a tough like 2 days just to be outside in those conditions, especially with sand whipping around, you could imagine. But basically from that point, we just ripped home. We ended up getting home around like 3 or 4 o'clock on Thanksgiving Day. So we drove like the other 5 hours on Thanksgiving Day, and that was a wrap. We were originally supposed to come home about Friday night, so I guess we came home about a day and a half early, but we didn't really get to see Zion. So we left out one stop on our itinerary. But I think it was also just getting hard for everyone because we were fitting 3 people in this space. And originally my sister had thought she was gonna sleep outside because she could sleep in the hammock, things like that. But it's just is too cold in the desert. And I honestly tried telling her that, but I just kind of bit the bullet and slept on the floor and gave her the bed. But you know, when it's 15, 20 degrees outside, you're not gonna sleep out in a hammock and whatever. So I think we were all just kind of getting a little tight. It was a lot for me right away with Luna and like this freshly built van and things like that. But on the flip side, it was an amazing, amazing test and just statement of how well the van works. I mean, I can't think of anything honestly that went wrong with the van. We really put Luna through the ringer, I think, and basically building a van with basically one, maybe 2 people living it in mind, it was cool to see how it held up with 3. I think this open floor plan space is like so incredibly huge, because when you have that many people in the van, it just makes it feel so much more open and allows people to kind of move around without feeling like there's just a bed stuck here. So that was basically my main goal with this whole build, was just make it feel like it's bigger than the 60 square feet it really is. So all in all, it was an amazing trip. There's also a little bit more exciting news, if you guys can hang in there for me. My YouTube channel has reached a status where I'm able to monetize my videos with ads. There's certain requirements you have to hit, that basically you need 1,000 subscribers and then you need 4,000 hours of watch time within the past 12 months. So that's been kind of a target that I've been slowly watching since about the summer, and it hit. So I'm not trying to get rich from YouTube. I have a great day job that allows me to do all of this, but I guess there is a cost of just like of doing all this and trying to pump out all the videos I do with working. So I don't want to make it a bigger deal than it is, but if you do see some ads in my videos, it's because I'm able to start to try to earn some revenue from doing all this, which I think is really cool, because my absolute lifelong dream would be able to travel and make videos and just share the beauty of the world with people who want to see it. So I want to always just be transparent with the channel and what's going on. So we're talking like cents right now, but I want to keep growing the channel. I think we're doing an awesome job, and I love all of you guys' support on my work and the videos and everything. So that's really, really cool. Along those lines, I'm going to be pushing hard in December. I'm trying to up to about 3 videos a week so I can hit 100 episodes of season 1 before the end of 2020. And then that way, when 2021 starts, I want to be rolling into season 2, and I have a cool sort of short film plan for the end of the year as well. So there's a lot that's going to be coming. If you guys want to see anything in particular about the van, about the lifestyle out here, like skiing, anything, drop some comments below. I do have a list of about 10 videos I want to make, but I'm more than happy to make something if you guys have questions or anything like that about the van. I think that would be really, really cool. So I know that was long-winded. Thank you guys for listening to me sit here and talk. I hope you guys are having a wonderful December. I hope you guys are staying healthy. I hope you guys are staying safe wherever you are. Thank you again for the support on all of the stuff that we do here. So take it easy, fam. I'll see you guys very, very soon. Be on the lookout for more videos, more content. Just, we're doing more, we're making more. We're just gonna be experiencing more in general. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see all of you guys in the next video. Take it easy, fam. Peace out. Woo!